city. And they made more headway in hand with five seats given to them, but further challenges down the road in 72, the laws will see. And the schism in the Democratic Party in this city became quite wild. Now I'm gonna skip some stuff here just to make sure I get everything in, just to cover other items that I want to catch in the 64 I lean forward. In 1963, gubernatorial race in the state of Mississippi, we saw the first legitimate Republican candidate, Rube Phillips. When I say legitimate, I mean we didn't have a name on the ballot, an R by, but not necessarily anyone who was a serious candidate. Rube Phillips had the first of his two races in 63. He was a Democrat turned Republican like everybody in Mississippi. Everybody started out a Democrat back then, but then they began changing jerseys down the road. Rube Phillips changed early in 63 and ran as a Republican and was the first one to get significant votes in that regard. The evolution of the two-party system in Mississippi. And now we've flipped over to the point where Republican parties almost as dominant as the Democrats everywhere. In 1972 was the year that both Bad Cochran and Trent Lott broke through and were elected to the U.S. House as Republicans, for House members. Coming forward, it was during that same period of time, 71, 72, 73, the negotiations were ongoing to reunify the Democratic Party into a biracial party in the state. 1975, we saw the first woman elected lieutenant governor, Evelyn Gandy, who held two-thirds of offices in the state of Mississippi and was one of the most qualified public servants I've ever known and watched. She had been head of what they call the welfare department back then. She'd been state treasurer. She was elected lieutenant governor, and everybody assumed she would be elected governor. And I can remember what she did, ultimately run against William Warner for governor, and in fact, LFT in the primary before getting beat in the general. And it was assumed that she was so strong in the primary that she would probably win the general election and become governor. But I can remember person after person in old Mississippi County that ain't no woman got to be with being governor. That just something I don't like. I love her to death. I contributed to her campaign, but I ain't gonna go for good. And so, a really great public servant missed out on her opportunity that I think that she would have made a fantastic career. She was, at the time she graduated from Ole Miss Law School, way back early, she was the only woman in law school. She didn't mind being around a bunch of men and telling them what to do. So, she would have done well. In 76, the Democratic Party reunited. It was on a very strict formula. If I recall, there was the examining committee was going to be comprised of 200 people. 100 had to be black, 100 had to be white. The party would be one party, all races, and it seemed that everything was over. But as we have seen since then, and in some ways all the way up to now, those who fought the long fight in the Democratic Party to reach that point were very reluctant to back off anything that they expected from the Tea Party. So we have seen continued internal squabbling within the Democratic Party. That's the only way I'm going to put it. number of, we see them all day and day and all of them now, and political ads are designed to carry a message. Well, here you have this other, a very, very popular public servant running against William Winter, who had feared his time may have come. And William Winter couldn't go out there in and overemphasize, "I don't want to vote for a woman, do you?" So William Winter would have the campaign there with him from 11:45 doing target practice at the police fire lane. Ha, 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 ha. William Winter. And of course, Miss Evelyn wouldn't go out there and shoot the pistol at it was designed to emphasize. Let's let the real man go. Miss Evelyn might sweep, but we don't want them. And it worked. They didn't have to say that. All they had to do was unload that pistol and fire at the Marines. And of course, in 82, during his time, pushed through the biggest education reform package passed, and literally is still going today. He might have got through being governor, but he certainly didn't retire. He continues to be William Winter, a uniquely favorable political figure. But it was just prior to 1983, who all remembers Bill Mullane's campaign?
Can I tell the bad story of that campaign?
Well, there's several bad stories.
The runoff of the primary governor's election, and Marty, correct me if I'm wrong, and Ms. Evelyn got some pictures of then Attorney General Bill Mullane that were compromising pictures at best, and her aides asked her if she would use those in a TV ad or in a newspaper ad, because it would ensure that she would finally become governor. And Ms. Evelyn, being who Ms. Evelyn Gandy was, said, "No, I will not use those pictures of the Attorney General, and I will run my campaign above board, clean and honest."
And of course, the rest of it came out anyway. Bill Mullane, who was single, although he had been married before, was accused of being caught down in the Ferry Street area of soliciting the services of transvestite prostitutes. Well, the rumors were everywhere, and you know, of course, you had all that, "Oh yeah, I saw it down there," and all that. Well, the Republicans had arrived on the scene, and Leon Bramlett was running against Bill Mullane, and Bill Munger and others saw a real chance for Brown to break through and be the first Republican elected. And so, lo and behold, they paid for a 30-minute program on Jackson TV station and had the transvestite sitting on the stage at the program testifying to the fact that Bill Mullane had indeed tried to solicit their services, and they were male cross-dressers sitting there with their dresses on. And that was assumed that it was going to sink Bill Mullane's ship. But I can remember sitting in the coffee shop down here at the hotel, just kind of reading the time for a meeting, kind of sampling of